राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हो हरिओम एवरीबॉडी
हरिओम स्वामी जी
प्रणाम प्रणाम तो पापा मेड इट पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू रीच आनंद आश्रम सत्संग समिति चेन्नई दिस मॉर्निंग एंड लकीली बाय हिज ग्रेस वी आर अगेन एम्पावर्ड टू कंटिन्यू द सत्संग विद यू ऑल वेरी नाइस For the past 2-3 days, through many friends, Papa has been reminding us that what is important in spiritual journey is giving trust to remembrance of God. How do I remember Him? We thought if we chant for some time every day, we will be able to remember Him. But experiences have taught us that during the chanting time, we are able to enjoy something. But immediately after the chanting time, we are back to our prior one, our smart self. So during the non-chanting time, how do I keep up the remembrance? It is the toughest challenge. Nobody can give an answer. Everybody has to find out one's own answer. But when we go through the teachings of Mahatma, in our case, Papa, we find that some clues have been given as to how he was able to do it. So drawing inspiration from those words, we can also try. And Papa has assured us, proportionate to the intensity we have, the intuiting reality will open up the path suitable for our equipment. How does he give us the clues? From within as well as from the top. Today, before, just before coming here to this hall, this is the shrine of Vayananda Shantapa Gandhi, Chennai. We are sitting in the shrine. Before we came here, just happened to see the June mission. So when we opened, we found one small narrative. There is a marvelous parable about a saintly master. Once a wealthy businessman was passing through the countryside. He came to know about the reclusive master living somewhere around there. Quietly. He searched around, soon found his residence. Upon entering, he was struck by how sparsely it was furnished. There was absolutely no furniture at all. There was not even a chair for him to sit on. Bewildered, the businessman asked him, "Where is your furniture?" Master smiled and replied with a query, "Well, where is yours?" Somewhat startled by the response, the visitor said, "I am just passing through." Master said, "I am also just passing through." That means the profession, when we try to keep up with remembrance, what is blocking us is the me and mine. No? Mind is profession. If you all go through the inquest of God, you will find it the first chapter itself. Papa gives this clue. Have we applied our life? We may be chanting, we may be reading. The last line of the first chapter. While desire for the enjoyment of worldly things were fast falling off, the consideration of me and mine was also wearing out. The sense of possession and relationship was vanishing. So here he gives the clue. What is blocking us is the me and mine. So here, when the visitor said, "Where is this for furniture?" He said, "What about you? I am just passing through." The master says, "I am also passing through." Just like a person when he is passing through, he doesn't carry his furniture. That is, we have all come here. It's a beautiful word of Papa, no? When the stage manager says your time is up, you have to quit, no? Without informing anybody, we have to quit. We don't have to take anything, no? We have seen everybody is quitting in the world. Think about it. We all hear, you know. It is limited to the hearing. We are not doing mananam. The more we do mananam, it will be reflected in our life. That is a test. Otherwise it becomes academic, theoretical, intellectual. No doubt, first intellectual knowledge is necessary, you know, for people like us, people who don't have that simple faith, you know. For the sake of our Madras friends, we will again repeat which we already repeated when we were in ashram. One ex went to the wife. This ex, you know, is supposed to be a spiritually evolved soul. So he asked the other man, "Suppose you have got 10 cows, will you give 5 cows?" He said, "Yes, I will give." "If you have got 10,000 rupees, will you give 5,000 rupees?" "Oh yes, I will give." "If you have got 3 dhotis, will you give?" "I won't give." "And if you have got 3 dhotis, will you give 1 dhoti?" "No, I won't give." "Why?" "Because the other 2 I don't have." So I can easily say, "I will give. But I have only 3 dhotis, I will not give." This is our state. Your money is my money is my money. See, this is a beautiful parable, no? We went there, the businessman asked him, where is your furniture? The master replied, well, where is yours? Somewhat startled by the response, the visitor said, no, I am just passing through. Master said calmly, I am also this one. So what is blocking us in remembering? This is a question we have to ask us. First of all, probably it might be due to the lack of concept of God. Second thing is our mind is fully filled up with me and mine. We have not given it space. Mataji bluntly asked, are you giving even a needle of space for Papa in your mind? By that what he meant, what she meant was, whether your sense of possession is going down, outwardly you may not be possessing, but what about the baggage you are carrying? Mataji bluntly said, even a needle top, that much space are you giving? So we have to do a lot of thinking about you. We may be hearing it. Just now we were sharing. In Bhagavad Gita, he has put it, tasmat sarveshu kaleshu maam anusmara yujyata. Therefore, at all times and in all conditions, remember me and fight the battle of life. Very difficult. Because we are not used to remember him while engage ourselves in various struggles in our life. We have set apart in our mind, when I do Ramna, I do Ramna. I do bhajan, I do bhajan. I do satyai, I do satsang. In that particular time, I try to become honest with you. But what happens during the non-chanting time, non-bhajan time, non-satsang time, non-satyai time? Am I able to keep up the same balance? No. Why is it that I am not able to keep up the balance? Me and mine. In the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, we are going to think seriously about the interest of God. But this is the manual of life. In the second chapter, if you find, Manana, you know, this is very important. We all probably unknowingly, we have not applied our mind more and more on this. The chapter begins with Mananam only. He says, one night while engaged in drinking the sweetness of his name, Ramdas was made to think in the following strain. That is Mananam, no? O Ram, when thy slave finds thee at one so powerful and so loving, and that he who trusts thee can be sure of true peace and happiness, why should he not throw himself entirely on thy mercy, which can be possible only by giving up everything he called mine? Thou art all in all to thy slave. Thou art the sole protector in the world. Men are deluded when they declare, I do this, I do that. This is mine, that is mine. All O Ram is thine. And all things are done by thee alone. Thy slave's one prayer to thee is to take him on the patra, as Vitthal Rao. Before he took that leap, he was very clear as to why he is taking that leap. That which is blocking my remembrance, I prayed to him to remove. By myself, I cannot remove. For some reason, he has given to me. So I pray to him. Please, enable me to remember you by removing the aina. In whatever way you, that is the whole thing, no? The whole 33 chapters, if you find, this is the real test, real test, real test. All O Ram is thine, all things are done by thee alone, thy slave's one prayer to thee is to take him under thy complete guidance and remove his aina. Second chapter. Only in the third chapter, he leaves adoption. First and second, you know, he prepares the ground. as Vitthal Rao. He was also subjected to all sorts of tests. One more similarity we could find is that the first sentence, right? Many people would not have noticed, that's why we are reminded. First sentence of the first chapter of first book, In Quest of God. For nearly a year, Ramdas struggled on in a world full of cares, anxieties and pain. It was a period of terrible stress and restlessness, all of his own making. In this utterly helpless condition, full of misery, where is relief, where is rest? This was the heart cry of Ramdas. The cry was there. We go to the last sentence. 37th chapter, last sentence. Ramdas cave, by Ram's command, in a cave called Panchapandava cave, in the Kadri hill, and lived there a serene life, devoting his whole time in talking about, writing and meditating on that loving and glorious Rama. So you suppose you starting. Start with terrible stress, end with serenity. So this is the message he gives. You and I are subjected to terrible stress, no doubt. But if we would follow the basic guideline given by him during the 34 chapters, probably we might also be able to lead a serene and peaceful life. And that was possible because constant remembrance of Ma Anusmari. During the entire Anusmaranam, you know, very important, not Smaranam. Anusmari. Continuous. Constant. Constancy is something that is hammered by Bhagavan. And whenever somebody was telling me, Vyavahara is tough, it is tough, not tough, toughness. Our mind will definitely say, I am not talking for my self interest. So I have to take this decision. I see this inequality. I see this unjust approach. I see this exploitation. So I have to act. Yes, you are all permitted to act. Spirituality does not say that you should not act. But don't take up on the ownership. God creates a situation. God places us, God makes us to see, to take the decision. If you bring this, you know, we have to keep on exploring. There is no general prescription. We all start by chanting. Yes, by chanting, but chanting with what attitude? We don't read out this portion every time because it might prove to be a disincentive for people who are chanting enthusiastically. But we have to know at one time in chanting, even if you chant for 100 years, you will be there where you are. So at the time of chanting, Papa says this word, if you remember right. If somebody says, oh, your chanting is very good, you are regular in chanting, immediately you must say, God makes me chant. God provides me opportunity to chant. God facilitates me to chant. God, so I must have some idea about God, you know, to say that. Otherwise I might be repeating some Papa's words. Then he dies, that you are doing. And this concept nobody can give from outside. This also varies from person to person, no? And we change the concept also as we keep on moving. Initially with form, initially seeing only goodness, initially seeing only beautifully, nobody, First you should see God in Rama, then you should see God in Ravana too. No? So our concept keeps on changing. We should know that. Nothing wrong in it. So he is the nameless formless of reality. Because I have got a name and form, it is difficult for me to conceal. So I give a name and form. And then through that name and form, I try to go beyond the name and form. Then only it will become universal, eternal. That will stay with me throughout. I develop a bhakti towards a particular deity or a guru. After some time, somebody shares this experience with a deity and guru, your mind starts. You will see in the puja room, photos of all, you know. Are we in a position to, Guru Mataji, I don't know whether you remember that, Guru Sudhi, she says, when she applied the kumkum on different deities, whom to apply first, the question comes. So every day she used to say, you know. Then finally she has written, after coming to Papa, we came to know that we have to go beyond deity. Because we, unknowingly, we don't accept that that is indwelling and all-pervading reality. We have the bhakti towards that form. There it ends. For spiritual unfoldment, for spiritual expansion. That is why you will find in ashram, Papa has made it clear that there is not any idolatry. Not that you are against idolatry. It is necessary to be. Otherwise, how do you get there? Buddha Bhakti, a great bhakta of Lord Krishna. Right? No. At that time. So he himself has written in At the Feet of God that when he closed his eyes, he saw Lord Krishna dancing. He was able to vividly remember even the dress, even the step. And for a moment he got immersed in that. But then suddenly, he prayed, I don't want this form. Because this form, it will come and go. I want that which stays with me always. So we should not belittle the importance of idol worship. We should not have an irreverence. It is not irrelevant. It has got its own place in all of our lives. But, we should not get stuck with it. Anyway, so when we say, we are trying to understand the concept, you know, that is how this topic is. So, right concept means this, when we keep on prompting deep within, mysteriously we will find the guidance coming from within as well as without. The prayer should be intense. I am unable to understand you. You are there. I believe in the words of my master. I believe in the words of Shastra. But I am unable to understand where are you, how are you functioning, how am I related to you, what is your role in my life. Yeah, it's like a frankly we must ask. Then, intuitively, you know, how are you talking? It could be like this. Did you plan for this life? Just like you decided to come from ashram yesterday, you arranged for the ticket, you got into the train, you reached the central, and from there you came by road. Like that, did you plan your birth? No. I started thinking and knowing after only 5 or 6 years, isn't it? Before that? So, was I consulted? Who did that?
These are some of the ways, by you know, not that this is the only way. These are some of the ways. If you go through in glimpses of divine vision, you have the thought. No. The first one, kindly go through that. First one, as you open, first one. A spiritual aspirant, Papa asks us to do what? Either you go to the origin of yours. How did I come to this world? How did I come to know about you? How did I come to know about the various methodologies? This is how you know. It is there here, but I don't know the it is there becomes that, that's all. Glimpses and very glimpses is up. So there, clearly meeting but we keep three members. You don't have one of the people. Father President, and those who say the word religion in the truth of that thing, now the religion in the house. He doesn't know who is talking about. Papa says, I have this. Trying to enter into the mysterious origin of your and world life. So who you are in reality is the real question. To arrive at this, we have to exercise the process of thought and discipline, transcend all human limitations. Set by the body mind, and then embarking on the realm of the spirit, realize your immortal, changeless, blissful nature. This is, we have to apply our mind. We would have bought this book and kept from the, brought it from the ashram and kept it here. Would also actually, then they will come down. But I honestly thinking, no, I would say that I should remember to I don't know if I can remember only if it is not. Either I should have experienced it. I must have, I should know, no, it is like this. What is only is explained in the knowable language, then I will be able. This is like the milk is about something. You are not fine. The thing which I know is really something. You are telling me something about that. To remember it, you know. How do I remember? If I don't know, how do I remember? How do I remember about him? So in his case, the problem is, he is not an object. If there is an object, somebody can go and say, you know, and explain to us. Suppose you have not gone to Sri Lanka. Somebody will have gone to Sri Lanka. He will say, you know, it is like our Kerala. Lots of coconut groves are there. Exactly like Kerala. If you have idea about Kerala, you have a hazy idea, not an idea about Sri Lanka. Because it is an object. Here it is not an object. Anybody who has played cannot say anything about it. In Tamil there is a word, you know, Indavar.
Indavar.
What does it mean? Those who have experienced, they will not be able to experience. Explain, sorry. Those who have explained, they have not experienced. Because why? Why did they say so? It is not in the knowable list.
It is a knower. Morning, every day when we do the yogasana in our shavasana, we say that, no? Finally, when we do that, the knower of the body is different from the thought. We get it, you know, we know that this is my body. He's my. That is, but this is what you know. Kshetra, kshetra. Kshetra and the knower of the kshetra. So here Papa says, I have to enter into the mysterious origin. How did I come? Mysterious origin. The seed that grew to be an individual now. More than 201 organs. Well coordinated, you know. Did anybody give a manual as to how the eye should work, as to how the ear should work, as to how the tongue should work, as to how the nose should work? Imagine. How the kidney should work, liver should work, how the heart should be, how the oxygen should go inside, how the excess of carbon dioxide should go out. How does the, when the food is taken, what a beautiful system is there to dissect it? And what is to be absorbed by the body? What is to be absorbed by the blood? What is to be absorbed by the bone? They are taken, rust is pushed out in the form of stool, in the form of urine. Who did that? He did. Let's say it's a mysterious origin. It can't be defined. Trying to enter into the mysterious origin of your and the world life. We started the question with how to remember. No? These are some of the proofs by which, by through manana, we try to remember him who is the indwelling reality. And unless and until we get some clarity about him, how can we remember? He said, Matra has to calm and strength. Therefore, at all times, that is not taken in all places. Remember me and then fight the battle. How am I to remember? He has asked me to remember, but while doing the household work, while doing the professional duty, while involving the social obligation. Not during my time, not during my Nama dancing time, not during my Bhajan time, not during my time, but during. When we keep on asking, he will take us to the words of the Spirit. He will make us to do Nanana. He will ask us to see how the creativity is there in the form. In the form of everything that we see. So this is the fundamental question faced by every aspirant, how to keep up the constant remembrance. He has taken us to a stage where he makes us to remember him in whatever form he makes us, probably this form, this attribute, without attribute, during certain times. That stage he has made us to reach. Not that we are zero now. But beyond which we have moved now. For decades we have been doing this. But we still feel that we are nowhere near to me. Why are you giving me this feeling when you are seated in silence? So this question, we will reframe the question in the way in which he will understand. He will understand when I put it through my own vision. Now what I do is, I quote Papa's word, I quote Mahatma's word, I quote Shastra's word. I am not quoting my words. So, until I quote my own, he will not answer. So, this has to come from this. The other day on Pujya Swamiji's Mahasamadhi Day, many of you might have heard it. He said we have to go to our own home. And we have to go as naked as we started. Without any appendage. Just like a child going and asking something to the mother, our mind should not say, I have known about you, I have heard about this, but that, no. Nothing. We should go to him as naked as we start. So Mahatma's words do help us, but we have to extract the essence and interpret it through our own language, and then pray to him, plead to him, appeal to him, cry. Then we still be here. This is what I have seen Papa say. This is what he is preaching to us. So let us try to keep the one word, you know. Remember, no. As we said day for yesterday, the November issue of Vision will be exhaustively dealing with this one. Remember and remember. In the fundamental thing of it, that's the end of the Ganta. In a fact, he didn't remember that. There is no problem for him. He remembers the Lord in his form, in everything, you know. There is no doubt. Somehow God has not given that, what is called, faith, unshakable faith. Or we can say, trust you here, man. He has given us faith. He has not made us to trust him. Every day, here also you repeat, you know, the universal prayer of Papa. Second word. O Lord of the universe, O creator, protector and destroyer of the world, I come in all humility to thy holy feet and surrender myself entirely to thee. Do we do that? Entirely will be what they have. So we think about it. Still we feel, no, we are the deciding factor. We are not surrendered. But we still need, keep telling. So one day we were asking Papa, why are you making us to tell lies? When we have not read it. Then he answers. What is the answer? Unless you are asking this question because you are not surrendered, you know? So how do you know that you are not surrendered? Only by remembering, every day you are remembered. I should not tell a lie. I should start surrendering. I should make a beginning. One person, 2%, 3%, like that I must start. So the somebody sort of come out to but maybe we have been shown the door, how to remember. We are still searching for him outside, so we don't remember. Our mind says we are remembering him during our chanting time, during our bhajan time, during our perfect time, during our satsang time. No. If it is remembering in that time, we have tasted the remembering. The formula for remembering. The technique of remembering, then we will be able to remember him throughout. So, what is it that you and I should do? We keep on asking him. We have been promised he will definitely approve as proportionately intensely. Tomorrow is Sunday. Normally, Sundays we have holidays. But tomorrow we will not have a holiday. We will continue this tomorrow. Hello. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Shri Ram Abho Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Abho
Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Abho Ram Jai Ram
Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram Jai Ram हरिओम हरिओम प्रणाम स्वामी जी।